Marble design with polygel, two different ways to achieve this look in this video coming up. Hello, I'm Anastasia and I will need white and dark pink polygel to do this design, non-acid primer to prep the nail, base coat and top coat. I will be using regular and dual forms. Let's start with the regular forms. This is the look we are trying to achieve here. First, prep the nail, apply dehydrator and primer, and thin layer of the base coat. You can use the same base coat as you use for gel polishes. The layer should be very thin. Cure in LED for 30 seconds. Now we're going to take white polygel and pink. It is better to use a little bit more pink than the white and slightly mix them, but do not too much because we don't want the colors to actually mix with each other, and then apply it on the form. I'm using the gel brush and the slip solution liquid, or if you don't have one, you can also use alcohol and start applying the product. I decided to do almond shape, so I always do the foundation first. This is not the whole nail yet, this is only a thin base, so I create the shape and the length of the nail, and we can already see a little marble look down there on the free edge. The main goal is to create both sides symmetrical and create the desired curve. Also make sure that it is all even. Now freeze cure for 20 seconds in LED and then I will slightly pinch it and cure the remaining 40 seconds. Now carefully remove the form. Let me show you how thin the nail is and how the curve looks and from the side view. As you can see, it is totally flat. Now let's mix a little bit more marbles. I'm taking more pink and white and mixing it again in a different directions. And we need more product now as we're doing the whole nail. Now take it with metallic spatula and apply it on the nail. You guys, this is so satisfying applying the product and you can actually see how these marbles are moving. And you can actually play with the product and create these lines as you would like them to go. But do not forget about the major rules of nail sculpting, such as cuticle area and sidewalls should be always thin, and the thickest part will be in the center of the nail, where the apex is located. As you go lower to the free edge, it should be thinner, but not too thin. For this length, I would recommend the thickness between the business and credit card. I'm not sure if the camera fully shows it, but the free edge is actually a see-through, so you can slightly see these marbles that we did on the first step. Now, with the brush, I try to make the surface as smooth as possible, so I will not need to file much. Also, always check your nail from the different views, not only from the top view, but also from the side view, from another side view. And if you notice that there is too much product, it is much better to remove it now rather than to file it later. Then I will cure it for 1 minute, slightly pinch, and cure for another 30 seconds. Then remove the sticky layer with the cleanse and I will slightly shape the nail. I'm shaping it with the file and there's not much to file on top, so I think I will go just with a buffer and buff the surface to make sure it is all smooth. After that, we will clean the dust and seal it with a top coat. I like it so much. This is definitely one of my favorite recent designs so far. It actually looks like a 3D marble or a rose quartz. I don't know. Let me guys know what you think in the comments. Cure the top coat for 30 seconds and now I will show you a different way to achieve similar look. This time we will be using a dual form. Now first fit it and make sure that it fits from all views and then the prep is basically the same. Apply dehydrator and non-acid primer. By the way, now I am using my left non-dominant hand so you guys can see that it is actually possible even with your other hand. Now base coat should be thin once again and then we will cure it in LED for 30 seconds. Yeah, I think you can tell that I'm working with the opposite hand. It's so slow. Now clean the sticky layer and I will be adding white, pink and white again. I think it will be better like this. And mix it once again and do not mix too much as we might end up with a light pink color and we don't want that, right? We want a fun marbles. Now take it with a spatula and apply it in the dual form and simply create the almond shape. With dual forms, I prefer to create the shape that I need right away, so I'm not doing square and then filing off the almond. I'm doing this curve right away, so make sure it's symmetrical. And you know what? I think I like this picture, this marbles from this view already. So I even feel kind of sad we're not using the regular forms now. Anyways, make sure that the shape is symmetrical, and the good thing about the dual forms is that we can see the result right away. So this is how the nail will look like at the end. Once you reach the cuticle, slightly press and carefully turn the finger around, and with your brush and slip solution liquid, fix the other side of the nail. After that, we will need to cure it for 1 minute in the LED, and here we go, we're almost done. Now clean the sticky layer from underneath and slightly shape the nail. We don't need to file the surface as it is already smooth, we only need to shape the nail. And sometimes we also need to file the cuticle area. I usually use the carbide cone-shaped bead for it, and then I will seal it with a top coat. So I think this nail has more white in it, and to me it looks more like marble or some winter swirls. Cure and we are ready. So now we have two different ways to achieve a similar look. Let me guys know what do you think, if you enjoyed this tutorial and if you would like to do something like that in the future. If you will, I will highly appreciate if you will use NailCo hashtag, which is the same as my channel name, so I can easily find your pictures and like them. Thank you so much for watching. If you're first time here on my channel, consider subscribing as I post new tutorials just like this one every week. And I will see you in my next one. Goodbye!